The project is essentially to promote regional specialization among universities and to address challenges within the region, and of course to build the capacities of universities. It's about result. It's a result-based financing. And what that one means is that you can focus on some few outcomes that you are expecting from the project. So for example, we are trying to do that by improving access in terms of science and technology into postgraduate programs. We are trying to improve the quality by increasing the number of students with master's degree and PhDs. And of course, in those areas that can impact the society and of course the countries and in which they are working. Because at the end of the day, this is the right time for this, especially in Africa, when you are now talking about non-mineral growth, like in Nigeria, non-oil growth. Without oil, is there any other areas that we can look to support the government? And part of it is science and technology. So we are thinking if we can focus on some few areas and try to see how we can link our universities to other universities in other parts of the world, if we can see how we can link our university to the private sector, and of course the professional associations, that so that that one can help us to improve the quality, the relevance, and the demand.
We have developed new programs, which we have called Masters and also PhD in Agricultural Science and Sustainable Environment. We have master students and PhD students from all over Nigeria and the regions. As of now, the PhD students, I think they should be up to 35 or 40, if I'm not mistaken. And then the master's students, close to that number.
My research is focused on using these animals that we have behind us to test the effect of turmeric powder on the reproductive parameter, growth, hematology, and physiological responses of this animal. The main reason why I want to do to test the turmeric is because it has been found that in livestock production, there are so many challenges, but one, methane production is one of the major challenges we have, because as we can see now, the global warming and the global change that we have is a result of accumulation of greenhouse gases. And the livestock, ruminant precisely, are the major producer of these methane gases. And turmeric has been said that it can reduce methane production by 30%. What CADES is preaching is to see that how what we are doing here, how an average Nigerian can make use of it. Not that we just publish something and we end up in the library. We have both theoretical experience, we have practical experience, and we have been exposed also to industrial experience, meaning that we acquire what you are supposed to acquire in the class. Like this program, for example, we take lecture for a period of a whole year. We're introduced to some courses like agriculture and climate change. So, like as at now, no other programs is doing some of those climate change courses.
When they get that, they will... The students are given opportunity to interact with industries of their choice, and for at least 3 months, then come back to the faculty or the supervisor and discuss the problems, and then form a study topic around that problem or issue. So the center and the industries will co-own the research. And when they do it, we believe that the results that will come out of this kind of studies will be novel. And moreover, they are demand driven, because we have identified a kind of a gap. So we want to bridge that gap.
My research study is based on bioavailability and utilization of copper from inorganic and organic sources of copper. I had my internship at Norgem Nigeria Limited, which is a representative of Novus International USA, and I was able to promote their new product, which is the organic copper source. In Nigeria, the premix industries, they make use of inorganic copper source. I'm a monogastric specialist. So in terms of your poultry, copper has a lot of functions, but now a lot of research has been done, and we are able to see that because this copper sulfate is inorganic, it has a lot of detrimental effects to our animals. Novus, they were able to produce an organic copper source. And they told me that, okay, can I make use of this organic copper by trying to include it, use it for my own experiment. So afterwards, I'll be able to give them my own result. And I said yes. So because of that, I was able to coin out my topic, my research work on that. The courses I undertook when I was doing my class work is different entirely from what they do during the regular masters. For example, I was introduced to animal welfare. We've been dealing with animals. I'm an animal scientist, but I've not been taught. I didn't know anything about welfare. And apart from that, I was able to meet a lot of people. This program is not only for we Nigerians. We have Togolese, people from Sierra Leone, people from Ghana, and lots more. So we were able to interact.
The type of collection was? My research area is on non-ruminants, which is poultry. I am looking at the anticoccidial activity of black pepper in layer birds. I did my internship in Gambia, and I am to do my research here in Nigeria. We all know that using conventional medicine to treat coccidiosis, you'll have antibacterial residue, and it's of a health concern. So this is an area that I think in future we'll build on it, and it will help to reduce the antibiotic residue on food animals that we consume. Gambia have one government university. It's a young university. It's about barely 10 years or so old. We do not have some advanced programs like this university. My short stay in Nigeria has exposed me to that line of thinking to bridge indigenous research, build knowledge between Nigeria and my home country. Currently, we're working on how to send more Gambians to this university for this program. Even when I go back to my country, the Gambia, I'll continue to work for the government and also to build on the relationship between the university and my country for future scientists to graduate from this university and go back to building capacity of the country.
At the other layers of this project was what we call regional international collaborative work. At present, our project coordinator is in the United Kingdom and should be having a meeting with the Director of Natural Resources Institute. We are in contact with our colleagues in Togo, Cameroon, Canada. We are also in contact with our colleagues in Denmark. The second point is that World Bank insisted on both the national and international accreditors. So, and there's no way we cannot accredit ourselves. So we have to go to the international sphere. You know, the MIE structure framework of World Bank is result-based. So, and if you did not achieve the result, they will not reimburse. So, and this is a very good step to make sure that organizations actually achieve the research outputs and the expected outcomes at the end of the day. So it has added more to our asset and our strength. And I think the university is also working seriously to be able to sustain that momentum.
There's a clamor for these centers of excellence, for selectivity, to solve regional challenges. Two, to make sure we build the capacity of Africans themselves to be able to solve, to be able to try and look at the issues from their own perspective. And we have to strengthen the system so that they will also be a player in terms of contributing to the global discussion. So instead of every time people talk about brain grain, brain drain, what we should be talking essentially is about brain circulation. How do we continue to circulate? So it's not about location of where you are, but how do you be able to use where you are and contribute to the discourse in terms of what research area we are trying to do. So if an African is now in developed country, in Europe or in US, it doesn't really matter. You can be there and be trying to contribute to solve problems of Africa. And if you are Africa too, you can be bringing your dimension to be able to, like what happened during the time of Ebola. Redeemer University came out, it's a Nigerian university, it's a private university. And the response, instead of doing the analysis outside the country, everything was done within Nigeria. And what does that mean? Response rate to the problems. And that's why it didn't spread in Nigeria. It's also, it's in terms of how do we leverage on government-owned resources too, so that at the end of the day, that is the only way to sustain some of this effort, is how do the government of Africa or Nigeria, how do they use their own resources to deliver better service for their own people? I think that is the bottom line. It's not in terms of the money coming from outside alone, but if you put good money into a bad system, it may not make any difference. But if you put good money into a good system, then you accelerate development. So that instead of everybody talking, we need more money in your university. Yes, we need more money, but we also need more results. And that is the paradigm shift. More result, more money.